गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, सो हियर वी वेयर दैट इज आवर एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ वेल्डेड जॉइंट ओवर द रिवेटर जॉइंट. आई हैव ऑलरेडी सेड अबाउट द रिवेटर जॉइंट एज वेल एज द वेल्डेड जॉइंट ऑल्सो. सो व्हाट आर दोज एडवांटेजेस और व्हाट आर दोज डिसएडवांटेजेस कंपेयरिंग बोथ ऑफ देम. सो फर्स्ट इज द एडवांटेजेस. सो वन बाई वन I'm repeating the point. What are those advantages of welding joint over a riveted joint? So the welded structure are usually lighter than riveted structures. This is due to the reason that in welding, gussets or other connecting components are not used. Likewise, in our riveting joint, the rivet, it is a specific material or a specific fastening component that we are using there. But in welding joint, there is no specific component we are using. Here only a molten metal or a filler material, by that we can join the two plates either or the two rods also. So the point two is the welded joint provide maximum efficiency, which is not possible in case of riveted joints. Next is alteration and additions can be easily made in the existing structures. As the welded structure is smooth in appearance, therefore it looks pleasing. Yes, because in welding joint there is no special or different material or different component is used. But in riveted joint, a specified rivet we can use there. So there is the head part of that rivet, there is the shank part of the rivet, there is the tail part of the rivet. That's why it's not looking the comparing them pleasing than the welding joint. In welded connections, the tension members are not weakened as in the case of riveted joint. Next is a welded joint has a great strength. Often a welded joint has the strength of the parent metal itself. Sometimes the members are of such a shape that they afford difficulty for riveting, but they can be easily welded. Next, the welding provides very rigid joints. This is in line with the modern trend of providing rigid frames. So it is possible to weld any part of structure at any point, but riveting requires enough clearance. And the last part is the advantages of welding. The process of welding takes less time than the riveting. This is the main important factor or the main important point of the advantages over the riveted joint. So next is our disadvantages of the welding joint. So since there is an uneven heating and cooling during fabrications, therefore the members may get distorted or additional stresses may develop. It requires a highly skilled labor or supervision. Since no provision is kept for expansion and contraction in the frame, therefore there is a possibility of cracks developing in it. And our last point is the inspection of welding work is more difficult than riveting work. Here are the types of welding joint. There are following two types of welded joints are important from the subject point of view. That is, our first is lap joint, or you can say it fillet joint, and the second is the bore joint. These two types of welding joints are there, likewise your riveting joint. So what is lap joint and what are those categorization of the lap joint? The lap joint or the fillet joint is obtained by overlapping the plates and then welding the wedges of the plate. The cross section of the fillet is approximately triangular. The fillet joint may be, this is the type of lap joint, and the fillet joint may be classified into three types. One is single transverse fillet joint, double transverse fillet joint, and the last part is parallel fillet joint. So here is the single transverse fillet joint, double transverse and parallel fillet joint. Those are the diagram of this lap joint, or you can say it is a fillet joint. So here if there is welded in one corner, this is known as the single transverse joint. If there is welded in two corners, this is one and this is two, that is called as double transverse fillet joint. And this is look like that parallel fillet joint. After lap joint, we have headed about the butt joint. So what is butt joint? The butt joint is obtained by placing the plates edge to edge, and in butt welds the plates edges do not require beveling if the thickness of the plate is less than 5 mm. On the other hand, if the plate thickness is 5 mm to 12.5 mm, the edges should be beveled to V-shape or U-groove on both sides. So this is the shapes of that butt joint. This is the square, this is closed square, this is single bevel, this is single J, double bevel, double J, single V, single U, double V, W, flange or T. Those are the butt joint shapes of welding joint. So next is our to find out the strength of the transverse fillet welded joint. So it is a we have already discussed that the fillet or lap joint is obtained by overlapping the plates and then welding the edges of the plates. So the transverse fillet welds are designed for tensile strength. This is the transverse fillet is known as designed for the only tensile strength, not the shear stress, not the compressive stress. Let us consider a single and double transverse fillet welds. There is two condition. One is single transverse fillet joint and next one is double transverse fillet joint. So this is the diagram of the transverse fillet joint, where the L is the length, that is shown in this figure. P is the strength, that is shown in figure, that is the tensile strength, or that is the welding thickness, that is denoted as S. So here are the denotations or the formulas. So let T is equal to throat thickness, S is equal to leg or size of the weld or thickness of the weld, and L is equal to length of the weld. So we find that the throat thickness will be T is equal to S, that is our thickness of the plate, into sine 45 degree, that is our 0.707 S. So minimum area of the weld or throat area, that is denoted as A, is equal to throat thickness into length of the weld, that is T into L, is equal to 0.707 into S into L. So here we are using the tensile stress in the transverse fillet joint. So sigma T, here it is sigma T, that is our tensile stress. If sigma T is the allowable tensile stress for the weld metal, then the tensile strength of the joint for single fillet weld will be P is equal to throat area into allowable tensile stress. So we know that we have already find out what is throat area, that is our 0.707 S into L into sigma T. So and tensile stress of the joint for double fillet weld, that is P is equal to 2 into 0.707 S into L into sigma T, that is find out that 1.414 into S into L into sigma T, where S is equal to thickness of the weld, L is equal to length of the weld, and your sigma T, that is our tensile stress applied on that fillet joint or transverse fillet joint, either that will be the single transverse or that will be the double transverse joint. So next one is our strength of the parallel fillet. As we know that the fillet joint is three types. One is single transverse, double transverse, and last part is parallel fillet joint. So we have already studied about first is single transverse joint formula and double transverse joint formula. Here is the strength of parallel joint.